Virtually everyone on Earth right now realizes we are living in a chapter of history due to the coronavirus global pandemic. When we look back at past events like the Ice Age, for example, or the time the pyramids were built, or even relatively recent events such as World War II, we sometimes get a surreal, romanticized feeling of these events. As through all of history, is already written down for our leisure, not realizing the ink is not yet dry, and we are not immune to big events. Approximately 640,000 years ago, the Lava Creek eruption was such an event, when the last full-scale eruption of the Yellowstone Supervolcano ejected approximately 1,000 cubic kilometers of rock, dust and volcano ash into the sky, literally shocking the world. Granted, the chances of this supervolcano erupting in our lifetime are extremely small, approximately 1 in 700,000 every year. It is still a bizarre fact about the human psychology to know that there are people with far less odds waiting to win the lottery. Geologists are closely monitoring the rise and fall of the Yellowstone Plateau, which has been rising about 1.5 centimeters per year, an indication of changes in magma chamber pressure. A study by the University of Utah scientists found that the size of the magma body beneath Yellowstone is significantly larger than had been thought. Of course, predictably, some media reports were very hyperbolic in their coverage, so the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory issued a statement on its website stating, "Although fascinating, the new findings do not imply increased geologic hazards at Yellowstone, and certainly do not increase the chances of super eruption in the near future. Contrary to some media reports, Yellowstone is not overdue for a super eruption." In 2017, NASA conducted a study to determine the feasibility of preventing the volcano from erupting. The results suggested that cooling the magma chamber by 35% would be enough to forestall such an incident. NASA proposed introducing water at high pressure, 10 kilometers underground. The circulating water would release heat at the surface, possibly in a way that could be used as a power source. If enacted, the plan would cost about $3.5 billion. Nevertheless, according to Brian Wilson of the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, a completed project might trigger, instead of prevent, an eruption. If we are extraordinarily lucky and happen to live in a time during the full eruption of the Yellowstone supervolcano, we would witness a mega-colossal force of nature releasing more than 2,000 million tons of sulfur into the atmosphere. The volcanic ash and droplets of sulfuric acid obscuring the sun would cause a volcanic winter lasting up to 10 years, resulting in large famines due to the destruction of crops and vegetation. On the other hand, with advances in geoengineering, we could harvest the energy underneath the Yellowstone to power the entire planet twice over. But that's for another video. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.